Welcome back. It is Game On, a 99.3 Nigeria Info. You minor Latin alongside I Am Brownish. We heard from the Accra United manager who sounded quite deflated. How about the man who secured the league's first away win and the first for insurance since 2019? Monday Odige.
I want to give God the glory for the result of the game. The result of the game to me did not actually show the performance on the field of play. The home team was a more mature side and a more experienced side. So like I said, I want to thank God that we're able to come out with some result here. Insurance is in the league for the first time and preseason. It gave us an idea of what the big teams in the league will be like. Accra United is one of the big teams. They've been champions in not too long time from now. So to me, all we went back home to do was to work on the corrections, the mistakes we made, and then try to build on our strengths, our mentality. If you're not strong, you can't play in Nigerian league. So I guess those were the things we did. And like I said, fate smiled on us to get the goals when we did.
What can I say? As a happy man, and give it all praise and thanks to God Almighty. Okay, welcome back to the broadcast. Just before we dovetail into some European conversation, Brownish has got 5,000 naira to give away on the show. We've got so much money at times we forget to give out.
I mean,
don't know why we do that. This guys I have in this team. All right, so Brownish, you've got a question. We'll be heading to the four lines, but if you desire not our 5,000, go ahead. Just tell us about the NPFL, your expectation for the new season. Who you fancy would, at the end of the Abridge campaign, be champions? If you're a Bendel Insurance fan, I'd like to hear from you what you make of that historic win in Accra on Sunday. So, let's head to the phone lines.
0700-993-993-993.
The alternative line for the latest, 01465-7190. Join the Game On conversation. If you're also a tennis fan, we spoke about Naomi Osaka. She's out of the Australian Open, which gets on the way. Just in a few days to be exact. It starts on the 16th of this month to the 30th. As I mentioned, about 76 Australian dollars for the eventual winner. Nadal as king of the men and Ashley Barty for the ladies.
Hi, my name is Rekia Yusuf, your favorite TV girl Mimi. Keep listening to Femi and the Gang.
All right, let's see if we've got a call out on the broadcast. Hi, good evening to you. Yeah, the gremlin's always the first. Just say, hey, Emmanuel, we do. Hello. Okay, it's not often you find computers birthing twins. It happened tonight. Your life in Nigerian, for what's your name and where you calling from? Hello.
Wow.
Welcome.
Good evening, Nigeria Info.
It is Nigeria Info, yes. Good evening.
Hello. Good evening.
Hi, good evening to you, yes. Oh, he wants to play the hello game. Wait for Brownish. Hi.
Hello.
Hello.
Good evening.
Good evening to you. What's your name?
My name is Samo from BGC.
Samo from Victoria Garden City. Nice one, bad guy. Okay, Samuel, go ahead. What do you want to talk about?
I'm so glad that Nigerian Football League is back again. Mm-hmm. And at least, even though it's not really back fully, mm-hmm. we still manage the one we have right now. And I'm so glad that seeing Bendel Shore and a new team coming from relegation and getting their first win away from home, and it's a pleasure. It's cool and nice. And I can't wait to see my Rivers United performing and giving me those magic and those wonderful style of football. And my team Chelsea, it's unfortunate that we are going through difficult times these days. And
yeah, there'll be time to talk about blue is the color, football is the game, we're not blah 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 and whatever the anthem says. Okay, I was squeezing one more, but thanks for calling, though. Samuel from VGC.
Good evening, Emmanuel.
Hi, good evening to you.
Good evening, Brownie.
Good evening.
Yeah, Emmanuel, can we say it is like insurance or Benin? Because, yeah, I don't call it Bender Insurance anymore. It's insurance or Benin.
Anyhow.
Can we say insurance or Benin defeating Accra United in the next of Champions Stadium? That means that insurance will be the next of Champions. Next Champion.
It can't be Champions, no.
Hey, Emmanuel.
No. The answer is
we are the next champion. We are the champion in waiting,
Emmanuel. Collect these 3 points and go.
Eh? It's not easy. See, to go to Aqua Nesso, Champions Stadium and defeat the OT. Not just by penalty, not just by one goal margin, but by two goal margin. Keeping a clean sheet on that process.
Yeah.
This is what you get when you are from where you are from Benin. We are the best. See, for now, Osaka Emmanuel. Eh?
Yes, please.
I don't pity this lady.
Okay.
See, she decided to make Serena retire on time. She made that lady cry. Most of the time, she did not pull out from all those tournaments. Now that Serena have retired, she wants to be pulling out from many for some tournaments. I don't pity her because for what she did to Serena, I can't pity her anytime. Thank you very much, Emmanuel.
Thank you so much for calling. I said that was going to be the final call after this has been beeping for the last 45 seconds. Hello.
Hello?
You're live for Nigeria Info. Hi, good evening.
Yeah, good evening.
Welcome.
Hello?
Hello.
Yeah, good evening. Moyo on the line.
Moyo, welcome, Moyo.
Omegondo.
Okay.
Can you hear me?
I can. We
Very
all.
Clearly.
Yes, yes, we can.
Okay. I'm talking about the EPL in the Premier League in Nigeria.
Yes.
I'm not a fan of Premier League in Nigeria. But now, I think I've tried to be watching it once in a while. Because I didn't see anything that I'm very interested in the Nigeria Premier League.
Okay.
But I'll try to watch it once in a while.
That's good.
You understand?
Yes, I understand. All right. Thank you so much, Moya. We'll keep our 5,000 for now. But Brownish has a cover. Just getting the signal that this broadcast is live on YouTube and the Nigeria Info channel. Not sure why. What's up, Adovai? Why are you putting me all out there, man? Anyway, so it is the Nigeria Info YouTube channel. That's Nigeria Info. Just search Nigeria Info on YouTube and you can see what's going on in the studio. Now I can't pick my nose. Eh? I've got to be self-conscious. Not that I do that, I'm just saying. Let's proceed and just have that conversation. Something remarkable going down in Spain. Ousmane Dembele. It's the part where Brownish would have to talk more because Dembele did something magical. Scored our first half winner as Barcelona moved 3 points clear. At the top of La Liga, they urged that win. It was against Atletico Madrid. Sweet side foot finish following Gavi's layoff. But side battlers finished with 10 men. Stefan Savic and Ferran Torres dismissed for a scuffle just before Brownish comes in. Sevilla also had a win 2-1 against Getafe. Rayo Vallecano lost at home to Betis 1-2. Almeria lost at home to Sociedad. Espanyol 2-2 against Girona. Mallorca 1-0 winners over Valladolid. Villarreal 2-1. For Real Madrid, Valencia 0-1 against Cadiz and Elche against Celta Vigo. I'm just noticing the Madrid results live on the radio because for the last 48 hours it's just been NPFL in my head. But Brownish, what a weekend for Barcelona fans.
Oh yeah, most definitely. What a weekend for Barcelona fans. And when you said the Real Madrid scoreline, I chuckled a bit because, yeah, I was a witch when Real Madrid were playing and I fully own it with my chest. But yeah. Villarreal actually played much better than Real Madrid in that game, albeit the fact towards the end of the game, Real Madrid came back and then it was always a scuffle and it was not finished until the 90th minute. But for the Barcelona game, that game had you on your toes. It was a game between two heavyweights, right? Barcelona went to the capital to, you know, go face Atletico Madrid and Ousmane Dembele getting the goods again. I remember earlier that day, the Barcelona official handle had posted a video of Messi giving Dembele an assist. I think one of his first games, you know, against Atletico Madrid. Dembele scored. And it just seemed very prophetic, considering the fact that, you know, eventually Ousmane Dembele did, you know, get the goods against Atletico Madrid. This time it was that move was started by Pedri. Absolutely fantastic. Drifted into the box. Yeah. Golden boy. From one golden boy to the other. Gavi shielding the ball again. And then eventually laying it off to Ousmane Dembele, who didn't take an extra touch. He just smashed it right into the corner, beating, you know, the Atletico goalkeeper. I've got to say, it was a great move, but, you know, Barcelona could so easily have been pegged back. Ronald Araujo doing the job at the other side. Marc-Andre ter Stegen had to make multiple saves, you know, and while it was a good result, you have the feeling that, you know, it could have gone either way. It could have been a draw. Barcelona could have lost by at least two or three goals. And yeah. Barcelona could also have won because, you know, they also put a bit of pressure on Atletico Madrid up to a center point. But I will say that is, you know, that is good for Barcelona right now. They're 3 points ahead of, you know, Real Madrid, who was in second right now.
Yeah.
The points that they threw away, you know, when they drew against Espanyol and then eventually I think, did they lose? It skips my mind now. Yeah. But the point is, they've won one of their very key games out there in the capital. And this one was against Diego Simeone's Atletico Madrid, who, by the way, are not doing so fantastic in La Liga. But it is what it is. And for Barcelona fans like me, and as a fan, I'm speaking now, not as, you know, an analyst, but as a fan, fantastic. As an analyst, it was a great game. And it was one of those games that you would like to watch as a neutral.
Fascinating. Yeah, somehow I don't know why I left out that part. This could have ushered us into the La Liga conversation. But that's it. Madrid losing to Villarreal. Brownish says he was responsible for that defeat to the White Angels. But 3 points above Real Madrid, 16 games played.
Man, Barcelona have had...
Being favourites?
No. It's too early. I mean, even if you're... You've got to be 5 points against Real Madrid with one more game to play to be favorites. They're that kind of team. So Barcelona just needs to do what they've been doing. Take it one game at a time and just try and win the next game. You're only as good as your last game. Barcelona had an okay last game. Not a good last game, but an okay last game. We can clearly see what Xavi is building. Some people are not as enthusiastic about it as other people are. But the point is, regardless of whatever is going to happen, Xavi is currently the... manager of Barcelona. Sometimes he's getting the job done. I mean, Barcelona have the best offensive record in the entirety of La Liga this season. You know, they've scored the most goals and conceded the least, if I do say so myself. And most of those goals were actually conceded against Real Madrid. So, pretty interesting. They went to the Vanda Metropolitano and then they kept a clean sheet. That's a big, big deal, especially against Atletico Madrid side. Griezmann, if I come for you.
No, please don't come.
Almost scored. But it was a game that kept you at the edge of the seat.
Yeah, for La Liga fans, bottom three teams, Cadiz, Espanyol and Elche. Somewhere in between you'd find Valencia in 11th place. Let's head to Italy.
Hi guys, I'm Victor Simeone. Keep listening to Femi and the Gang on Nigerian Info.
That's a man who was part of that brushing off Sampdoria. 2-0 Napoli won on Sunday. Goals from the Nigerian and Elf Elmas putting the Serie A leaders back on the winning track. They got a penalty, just to mention, 6 minutes in, but a certain man whose name is unique, Matteo Politano, somehow just couldn't convert it. Osimhen then had the opportunity of scoring the first. He did that in the 19th minute. His 10th Serie A goal this season. This man is top scorer and he could lead them to the title.
Yeah, he's having a fantastic season. And he's not just... I think last season when he joined Napoli, he wasn't firing on all cylinders and all of that. And shout out to the manager for still believing in him. This season he has been absolutely unplayable. A player who went out on injury came back and continued his run of form. And this is not form. At this point, we acknowledge that this is class because he has done it away from Napoli. And now he's at Napoli and he's getting the numbers again. I mean, 10 goals. How many games have Napoli even played? They're currently in high contention for winning the Scudetto this season. And he's a huge, huge part of that. He doesn't even need a penalty to score a goal anymore, Victor Osimhen. He's one of those players. He's very physical. He's got pace, at least enough pace to get away from defenders. And he's not scared to, shoot from range. He's one of those players. His positional awareness is absolutely phenomenal. We could wax lyrical about how good Victor Osimhen is in front of goal, but the numbers speak for themselves, and he's one of those players, and I think Napoli would feel very, very hard done by if anything should happen to him at this point. We pray that he keeps going on this run of form and that he's very instrumental, and Napoli eventually put up, at the very least, a very good title challenge.
Just also noticed that this live streaming is on Facebook, and I've got a message to take on Facebook. That's Nigel Info FM. You could also search that on Facebook and enjoy the game and conversation. Ozo Francis Namani says he's watching live from Amangunze in Enugu State. Amangunze. Okay, I think I've got my Soweto tongue out. Let me find the...
Igbo.
Yes. Amangunze. Good evening from here. Hi, Ozo. Kudos to Victor Osimhen for increasing his goal tally to 10 after scoring as Napoli urged Sampdoria. Thank you for that message. The very first man to drop a message on Facebook. You would also go there and drop. By the way, they are about 8 points, Brownish, ahead of Juventus. I think they will win the Scudetto. They have to.
They have to, but I think it's too early. Juventus are only... it's not yet the halfway of the season, to be honest, if we're being honest.
They're going to lose 3 games.
Yes.
To forfeit the title.
Or not lose, but draw. Okay. At the very least, which is very possible in the Italian Serie A, if we're being honest. If they pick up three points in 3 games, that's almost like losing 2 games. and Juventus keep winning, I mean, it's one of those things. Mm. And I fully expect that, you know, Juve will try to pile on the pressure. The question now is, who can be more consistent? Up until now, Napoli have been the more consistent. Hopefully we get to see a very good Scudetto title challenge from everybody. Juventus look like they're coming back. How many years after Cristiano Ronaldo's left? So, shout out to them. And hopefully we get to see more interesting football, you know, in Serie A.
Just a roll call of the results. AC Milan played out that breathtaking 2-0 draw against AS Roma.
Sampdoria. That draw was interesting, I've got to say.
It was. I love that was for the draw, not for what I said. Sampdoria nil, Napoli 2. We mentioned that. Lazio and Empoli 2-2. Spezia goalless against Lecce. Salernitana 1-1 against Torino. Monza 2-0 against Inter Milano. Juventus 1-0 against Udinese. Fiorentina 2-1 against Sassuolo. So the bottom three, Verona, Sampdoria, and certain Cremonese, these are names that should be in the second division, not the Italian Serie A.
They could go to the second division, but it is what it is.
Okay, fair enough then. So how about that conversation about Roberto Martinez on Game One? He's been appointed the head coach of the Portuguese national team. He's Spaniard, he's 49, and they say coming to replace Fernando Santos, who had to resign after Portugal's quarterfinal defeat by Morocco at the World Cup last month. That night, brownish, the entire continent, to remember, was for Africa. And the reason why he no longer has a job, but Portugal have appointed Roberto Martinez.
I don't know why, to be honest. And not to be harsh, but Roberto Martinez has, in for lack of a better word, underperformed with one golden generation. And the Portuguese national team have a variety of young players, at least young forwards, you know. They've got a certain Ruben Dias is not necessarily young, but he's not old either, right? You know, they've got Rafael Leao, they've got João Felix, you know, they've got Bruno Fernandes, who's not old, but he's young, kind of, but he's not old in a sense. They have a team that is a very good team, you know, a certain Gonzalo Ramos, who got a hat-trick at the World Cup, right? So they've got a team, and I'm scared. I don't know what Roberto Martinez is going to do with this side. I understand very well that he's a manager that can get the job done, but the question is, will he get the job done with this side? We saw what happened with Belgium. The best that this Belgium's golden generation got was a bronze at the World Cup, when they could so easily have gone on to winning, you know. So I just feel like he's an underperformer at the very least on the international stage.
Wow.
From you, because you're only as good as your last job.
Yeah, his last job was a group stage exit
with a Belgian side that had Eden Hazard. It got a certain Lukaku, Kevin De Bruyne.
The players let the manager down.
Are they always letting him down? How about when they were playing their hearts out in 2014? In 2018,
now
I guess.
He's got the job. What do you say to the Portuguese people listening to you, Brownie?
I would say cross your fingers and hope for the best, in my opinion. It's like, he's a manager, he's got tactics, he's good. But the question is, will he choke when it matters? Will it restrict his airflow? I guess that's they appointed him, so they've got faith.
All right.
But football isn't played on faith.
Yeah, that's the man who, as I mentioned, was also in Qatar with the Belgian national side. He spent 4 years as a Wigan manager, including him winning the FA Cup in 2013. And just also had the opportunity of managing Everton. He finished fifth once and 11th twice at the Premier League. Portugal, his new country, by virtue of being the new manager, won the European Championship in the 2018-19 Nations League. During Fernando Santos's 8-year reign. However, they only won one of their three group matches in Qatar. Their campaign overshadowed by Santos dropping Cristiano Ronaldo for the knockout matches. So Santos gone. Ronaldo hasn't confirmed his retirement with Portugal. Do you think Martinez, just as short a sentence as possible, Brownish, can help Portugal achieve world success in 4 years' time?
That's what I'm scared of.
You don't think he can do it?
It's going to be a tad stressful. And
how does it sound like you don't like Martinez?
No, actually, I'm scared for Ronaldo, because if he comes back and he's got a manager who doesn't get the job done, it's going to be incredibly problematic. Personally, in my opinion, after Messi won his World Cup, anything that wants to happen can happen, right? But the fact is, for such premium players, you have to have a premium manager, and I think maybe Roberto Martinez might be the Mauricio Pochettino of international coaches, just saying.
All right, let's kind of cross the Facebook platform and squeeze in This message, Samson Lassisi says, hello, good evening. I see Napoli winning the Serie A and is asking the question if Brownie should be in the studio for the Arsenal game. He didn't say that. He actually mentioned he'd like us to do commentaries on that fixture. And yes, we do have our coverage team, Daisy Michael and Diesel, to call me and scream his lungs off. He always does that. Let's go and pay some bills. When we return, we'll cue that FA Cup conversation. Throw the phone lines open. Manchester City cruising to the fourth round with that. What's the word to describe what they did to Chelsea? Demolition, destruction?
Evisceration. Obliteration.
Right. If you're writing an article and you want to be humane, just say defeat. Okay, so the Chelsea fans don't die reading it. We'll be back.